I'm not sure. I think they busted, but whatever it is, we scored and we won.
We were just talking to Joe. He said after you scored, the stadium just got definitely silent.
Yeah, that's what you want. That's a great feeling. That's a great feeling, especially being here. Cleveland has a great fan base, but to have them go quiet like that, he's doing so much.
Talk about Garrett Wilson and just how you thought he played.
Man. Garrett's a dog, man. He's a great wideout, man. Real good dude. He prepares really well each and every week. We move him around from different positions, and he handles it really well. And today, he just came out here and showed what he can do. And I think he could do a lot more. He had a great game, man. Excited to see what he's going to do for us the rest of the year.
What's your respect level for Joe and just kind of doing what he's doing at age 37 and what kind of thing?
You said how old, 37?
For a while, yeah.
Man, a lot of respect for him. Just come out here and do what he does. I think 37 is that old, but for football, it's kind of up there, especially the shots that he takes. But he's a great quarterback, man, great leader, and we're happy to have him.
How much did this locker room need something like this
to happen? It was big, man. We knew what we wanted to do when we came in here, and we knew what it was going to take. It was going to be a physical game, a lot of grit, and we came out and we handled business.
You talked about the touchdown. What was your vantage point of the onside kick?
Man, that was front center. And we actually believed that we were going to get it. Borey does a great job with special teams, and they got a good scheme of onside, whatever it is. But we were confident that we were going to get it the whole time, and we did.
So when you got it, what's happening in terms of you guys communicating before the final drive?
There was no panic, which is interesting. MC, Coach before said, it's like the heartbeat of our offense. And that showed today. He was going up and down the sideline, keeping dudes locked in, making sure that we're engaged, and that we believed in ourselves that we're going to come out here and win. And that's what we did.
Have you ever been part of a game like that?
No. This is a crazy game, man. This is probably one of the craziest endings I've ever been a part of, and probably one of the greatest feelings, too.
What can it do for a team that is trying to find its way here early in the season?
Real good for us to get this type of dub early. A hard-fought victory, scratching and clawing. That's what it's going to take in this league. But luckily, we got the right dudes in this locker room to get it done.
Is this a great example of what Sal's talking about with the 60%?
No question. There's no question, man. He knows a few things. So that 60% really resonates with me especially. And I know it resonates with the whole offense. But he told us that those last couple drives, and that's all I was thinking about, 60%. So it definitely helps.